Concerning the violence in northeast parts of the national capital, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal has reportedly called for an urgent meeting at his residence. And in this meeting, MLAs and officials of the violence-hit areas of Delhi are expected to be present. Remember, so far, the Chief Minister has tried to stay away in terms of making any appeal or political statement related to the violence witnessed in parts of Delhi, whether it was earlier Shaheen Bagh Jamia or now the northeast parts, including Gokulpuri, Bhajanpura, Maujpur and Chandbagh areas in northeast Delhi. Today, he has called for a meeting at his residence and MLAs and officials of the violence at areas are expected to be present there. Let's go across to our reporters now. News editor Bhavtosh as well as Wajiullah are joining me for more inputs on the story. Bhavtosh, to you first. This is unprecedented. Five people, including a policeman, has been killed in the violence that we have witnessed in the capital in the last 2 days. Clearly, there is need for urgent intervention from the political leaders across party lines, whether it's the government at center or the chief minister of this of Delhi.
Preeti, the fact is that tempers need to be soothed and there should be an attempt by political parties to engage the elders or even the locals so that this violence that had unleashed northeast Delhi should end. In fact, early this morning there were reports of stone pelting coming from Maujpur as well as from Babarpur. There are reports that in Brahmpuri there were shots which were fired and rioting and stone pelting went on till 5 in the morning. And what is most disturbing, Preeti, is the fact that Delhi police appears to be helpless. Eyewitnesses in Maujpur have told us that when stone pelting was happening, instead of controlling the mob, several police personnel were sitting in a jeep and then they took a U-turn and fled from the spot. Now there is a genuine concern that Delhi police have failed to control this violence, and it all depends on paramilitary forces. Their numbers are very less, and Preeti, the fact is that it's a very congested part of Delhi, and these are very narrow lanes. These colonies have very narrow lanes, and that's the reason why the violence continues unabated since Sunday.
Right, and these shocking pictures really coming in from parts of northeast Delhi. This was just a day before Donald Trump was expected to be in the national capital, and it continues even today. Situation is not particularly calm, but what we are getting in terms of breaking news is that Delhi Chief Secretary has cancelled his pre-scheduled meeting with all the district DCPs in view of the prevailing situation. And we can perhaps go across to our editor, Internal Security, Nikunj Garg, who's joining me on the phone line now. Nikunj, the Delhi Chief Secretary there cancelling his meeting with all the district DCPs. This means that he is leaving the police to do the other urgent task of really monitoring the situation and controlling it in northeast Delhi?
Absolutely, Preeti. It's my sense that all the district commissioners of police now would be deployed at various points in northeast Delhi. They won't just be confined to their own district. And that is why, sensing the urgency of the situation, Delhi Chief Secretary Mr. Vijay Dev, who was supposed to chair a pre-scheduled meeting at 11:30 a.m. this morning to review the law and order arrangements and general administration cooperation with the Delhi police, has cancelled that meeting. He had issued the notice for that meeting 3 days back. It was supposed to happen at 11:30 a.m. this morning. But again, you know, he has informed the Commissioner of Police that officials from the Delhi Police need not come to the Chief Secretary's office in the Delhi Secretariat today. And that meeting stands cancelled. Probably he will recall that meeting once the situation normalizes in the national capital.
Right.
Quite clearly, Chief Secretary sensing that right now the time is for officers to be on the field and not in his chamber reviewing the arrangements.
Right. In fact, the priority for all the top officials of Delhi Police is going to be to control the situation in northeast Delhi. Thanks very much, Nikunj. In fact, we have a few reactions coming in from police officers monitoring the area. This is what they had to tell us.
Sir, abhi at present situation kya hai, sir? Aap logon ko kya knowledge mil rahi hai? Aur aage ki planning kya hai, sir, isko contain karne ke liye?
Dekhiye, jo kai ilake hain wahan pe lagatar stand off pure din chalta raha. गैदरिंग थी, उस पुलिस ने कंटिन्यूस जो है पेट्रोलिंग के जरिए फोर्स यूज करके भीड़ को तितर बितर किया. अलग अलग जगहों पे स्टोन पिल्टिंग की बहुत घटनाएं हुई, कई जगहों पे आगजनी की भी घटनाएं हुई, लेकिन सब जगह जितने भी रोड्स थे और जो संवेदनशील क्षेत्र हैं वहाँ पे कंटिन्यूस पुलिस प्रेजेंस बना के रखी गई. और जहाँ पर भी कहीं किसी किस्म की कॉल आई, इमिडिएटली फोर्स रश किया गया और वहाँ उसको कंट्रोल किया गया.
So do you have any official figure of number of people who have died or number of people who are injured?
जहाँ तक death toll है तो अभी तक तीन civilian और एक police personnel की death हुई है जो confirmed है और हमारे DCP साहदरा है जिनके भी चोट आई थी.
There have been reports and I have been out since the afternoon and we have done flag march from Pushta Road, Khajuri Chowk, Bajanpura Chowk to Wajirabad T point to 66 foot road. And last 3-4 hours we have been totally on the route march along with RAF and we have walked on foot and wherever we have found crowd we have dispersed them. And presently the law and order situation is under control and there are no noticeable reports of any violence right now. I have appealed to everyone and I would like to appeal again that we must all cooperate and maintaining peace and law and order in the area and ensure that no untoward incidents take place. I know about the death of our officer, head constable Ratan Lal. It was a very unfortunate incident. He got hit by a stone and he was rushed to the hospital but he succumbed to his injuries. Similarly, our DCP Shadra Amish Sharma, he also sustained injuries at the same time. He is also presently hospitalized. But about the other reports, I have been out in the area throughout. So we'll check up about what are the facts regarding each incident and then we'll take appropriate action.
What are the kind of information that you are getting in from your area?
जहाँ से भी हमारे पास वायलेंस की कॉल आती है कि लोग इकट्ठा हैं या स्टोन पल्टिंग कर रहे हैं, वहाँ पर लगातार पुलिस जो है पहुँचकर लोगों को वहाँ से डिस्पर्स करवा रही है और हम अभी भी इलाके में लगातार जो है एरिया डोमिनेशन कर रहे हैं और कोशिश है कि जो अभी लोग सड़क पे आइए उनको हम पीछे खदेड़ें.
क्या आपको लगता है कि सुबह असेसमेंट में कहीं ना कहीं गलती हुई, इसलिए डिप्लॉयमेंट थोड़ी कम हो गई और एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ जो हुआ वो शाम में हुआ? बहुत सवाल उठ रहे हैं सर.
नहीं, डिप्लॉयमेंट हमारा सारे स्ट्रेटेजिक प्लेसेस में था, संवेदनशील क्षेत्रों को ध्यान में रखे हुए पुलिस फोर्स का डिप्लॉयमेंट किया गया था और इनिशियली जहां पर पुलिस का डिप्लॉयमेंट था वहां पर तो स्थिति तुरंत काबू में कर ली गई और फिर कुछ एक नई जगहों से भी कॉल आना शुरू हुई तो वहां से हमने फोर्स को वहां मूव किया. अधिकांश जगहों पे पुलिस फोर्स के मूवमेंट के समय में भी बाधा आई क्योंकि लोगों ने रोड ब्लॉक करके रखी थी, उन ब्लॉकेज को हटाकर भी पुलिस पहुँची है और वहाँ पर भी जाके हमने एरिया डोमिनेशन किया है और स्थिति को काबू में किया है. तो लगातार पुलिस अभी भी लगातार लगी हुई है पुलिस फोर्स और इलाकों में स्थिति को नियंत्रण में रखा हुआ है.
सर, क्योंकि आप ग्राउंड पे काम कर रहे हैं सर, कब तक एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हैं नॉर्मल से? सर, एक सवाल बहुत ही क्लेशे सवाल है सर, लोग कहते हैं ये सवाल पूछते हैं आप, बट हाउ सून कैन वी एक्सपेक्ट नॉर्मलसी इन योर एरिया सर, बिकॉज थिंग्स आर एक्चुअली गोइंग आउट ऑफ हैंड्स नाउ.
बहुत जल्दी वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग और आज जो स्थिति रही है उसके मद्देनज़र हमने अपनी एक नई स्ट्रेटजी भी बनाई है और उसके अकॉर्डिंग वी आर वेरी होपफुल दैट कि वी विल बी एबल टू कंट्रोल दी सिचुएशन.